Assalamualaikum, welcome guys, developers. This is our final video for the Capstone project. Sorry, portfolio project. And in our previous two videos, we have made some analysis in SQL and then created in Python. And also built a machine learning model. And then now we will develop dashboard. We will learn step by step to develop statistic process to develop dashboard in IBM Cognos analytics. And for this, we have to launch our IBM cloud, and then I have two services over here. So now launch it. And click to launch it, and then after clicking this, we have this area on the page. Now we have to go to content, and then to go my content, and in my content I have some basic things that I have done before on my portfolio project Capstone. So now, as I said earlier, that we have made some analysis on movies data. So we use this movies CSV file to build our dashboard. To upload this file, we have to go to the upload data section and then just select the data where you have. And after uploaded it, it appears here. Just then just click it on and just create dashboard. There are lots of things over there. We will cover it in another video that will be only for IBM Cognos data analytics A to Z. Now for this video we are concerned about only creating dashboard. So create dashboard, new window will appear. Before that, I would like to discuss with you that I have made analysis for the dashboard using this file before, and why I am sharing this. Before making a dashboard, you have to have some idea what your stakeholders or what your managers wants from you. So what layout they want, what types of information would you like to show on your dashboard. For this reason, you have to make a plan that my dashboard should contain 5 rectangles or 2 rectangles or 4 rectangles, whatever. So in my case, what I will use, so to do this, I go back to my content, and before that I have made a movies dashboard happier. Just open it again for just a view that what I have made. So I have made it here for 4 or 5. So go to our dashboard and take this template. There are lots of templates based on your criteria, based on your use cases. You can use anyone. So for my analysis, or I have asked some questions to myself that what information should I put on my dashboard, or how my dashboard will look. So this is my selected and the power to select the selected it, yeah. Okay, just you can take the source from here also if you miss the last system. So this is the source file where we will build our dashboard. Now here you can see, if I just put it here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So dashboard, in my dashboard 1, tab 1, which is 5 panels over there. The numbering should be from here 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So first I have to edit the title. Let's say summary. So I would like to put all the summary over here, like ever is budget, ever is gross income, ever is gross, ever is rating, so etc. So now first panel or first rectangle, I would like to show the average budget. So I have to select the budget column over there. In the source file, movie, CSV, these are the columns. Okay, so I just select the budget column and then just drag and drop. Okay, when it appears blue, then just drop it. Release the mouse and then here it is. Now, what should I do? The first task is it's automatically sum up all the budget values, but I would like to show over is budget. So how should I do this? Select it and then here, okay, and then select the yes. It's auto sum, but I'd like to show the over is budget. So we did 4.6 million. Now it's time to align this rectangle into our desired rectangle. Okay, I would like to show it in my first rectangle. This is our first rectangle one, okay? Now, sorry. When you select this, there are two fields, two options over there, sorry, fields and properties. First, I like to make a border around this rectangle. So, for this, first properties and then general appearance, border color, black. Okay, and then go to the visualization. Look, from chart, we have to deselect it because I don't like to show this budget level over there. So, just deactivate this. That's it for the first rectangle. One more thing over there, like here, if you write budget, then our stakeholder can easily understand, wow, this is the average budget for movies. As you know, in our data set, we have the movies for 31 years, from 1986 to 2008, I guess, 2016, maybe. Maybe 2016. So 31 years movies database over there. Now for the second column, sorry, for the second panel or rectangle, what should I show over there? Now let's say average gross income. Just drop it here. Then I just select it and deselect it because my screen is little bit smaller, then I just need to make it little bit bigger. If your screen is bigger than mine, then you go to do this. Okay, just click it and see. Now, as like before, I just okay, so what should I do then? Okay, the first thing is that select it and sum average it, and then go to the general learn. If you missed any steps, just watch it again and again, then it will be clear to you. Just I would like to make this video as like as short as possible, so just like before, for this, I should say not gross. Revenue. It was revenue. So looks pretty good. And then go to the source again, and then in the next panel, what should I show? Okay. Let's see. Cover is store and cover is store. Okay. So hit here. Cover is store. Just put it here. Do the same thing. Sorry. This store, okay, and then go back to this and cover is almost the same thing, the repeated things and visualization chart element. I guess this looks okay, and from here you can full screen mode, then this looks good. So now I am using this pattern, okay. And now over here I would like to show Jenner and Buzzer. Okay, so to select multiple columns, these are the columns in my Excel file or CSV file. So to select the multiple columns, just hold Ctrl key and then just select the columns and then just drag and drop here. Move it. Okay, it shows automatic suggestion or automatic chart for me, but I will change it. One moment. Okay, before that, selected, go to the general properties. I do this every time. One thing I would like to do, I would like to make these designs, levels, vertical order. So, go to the chart. Show value labels. Sorry. Maybe different options. This label shows this item. maybe some the chart, I guess. Yeah. Wait a moment. I'll do this. Value axis evaluation show read lines responsive. Show value levels? No, I don't want this. Okay. This is native axis style. Show item axis title. Okay. Yes. Item axis level orientation, okay? Makes it vertical. And now I would like to change the chart type. Okay, so select it, go to here, change visualization. Then I would like to make it scatter plot. Okay, where it is. So there are lots of suggestions for you, all visualizations over there. You can just select one of them. Okay, just sorry. Okay, scatter plot. Okay. And then just another so burn section. Okay, just select it and then just for point values I would like first, and I would like to change x axis from budget to gross. Okay, because I'd like to show the gross income for different modes, the types. So should be there y-axis, and for x-axis I would like to show the movie types. Okay, and for points I would like to show the gross income. Okay, let's check it again. Yes. What is this? No, just it should be line chart, general and cross. Okay, just remove it, then just in source and gross. Select the chart type. Line chart. Then do the things that I have done. This reply. Good. Now just look, I'm doing the things what newcomers are, what the real scenario is. Okay, so we can just do this like this. And control plus S or manual save, go to the my content. I have to save it into my content and then name it movies one, because I have another one. Okay, movies one does it. So now I would like to show top. for worker, then hit the title from values. So in the first rectangle, I'd like to show the highest top 10 budget movies. Okay, top 10 budget movies. So budget and name. Select it. Select by equal. Pressing the control. There is a name, if you just missed some steps and then just select one column and forget to select another one, then just put the another column into the center and then it will show you the solution. So click on it, go to there, select the bar chart. Because I'd like to show top 10 or top 5 name of the movies. So now top or bottom, top or bottom, select right button, the budget, top or select top count and just show here what I have done. Okay, there are not only 10 movies. Look, 1, 2, 3, these are the 3, these are the first 3, 4, 5, these are the 6, these are the 7, these 8, this is 8, 9, and these are the 10. So one more thing I have to do, color, and chart. Go to the chart and show value levels, okay? Where? Inside the N. So look how it looks. Looks like, okay? So, looks pretty good. And now, top 10 movies by gross income. Okay? So, top 10 gross income by name. Okay? Look, automatically it appears a chart, but now so go to this chart visualization and it chart. Okay, look, clumsy. Then again, top or bottom. Good. Just elaborate it. Look, top 10 movies, okay? By means of gross income. So, change the picture of this. And as like before, go to the chart and show the levels inside the end. And looks pretty good. And the same way, we have here. Okay, let's take a look in our okay. What are the benefits of the companies? You can just edit. Top 10. Please. So, in this way, you can find out the rest of the things. I will show this video. I will upload the file on GitHub. So, also taking this in this process. Five types of movies by means of gross. Okay. Let's change it back to normal. No. Action comedy, five types of rules. So from here you can show these values from the top 5. Top 5, okay. Top 5, and then just top 10 companies by means of gross income. These are the questions you have to ask yourself. What kind of things you would like to do? That's good. Just go to the top 10 companies. Then and then okay, this one. Oops, okay. Now we have to test over here. Now just take a look on this. We have made some correlation in our Python output. You can just okay. Next, we will take part 23. Okay, and make the title it correlation on demographics, whatever you can say. Then we have made some correlation between budget and gross income and gross and gross income. So just this budget and gross. Look, it's automatically suggest a chart, but I would like to show it as like in our Python workbook chart. Okay, so go here. Now we have to use scatter chart that I states over there. Okay, so into the points section until it will not appear. Okay, it's just gross and budget. Let's start single point. If you have to mark it by gross point section, you have to mark it by gross. Hopefully, yeah. Now we can go as our Python program. Next. And for the second panel, we should make it gross and false, okay? Plus just make it delete, okay. And then as like before the chart. Go to the first section and each verse and see black. Okay. And now just the last one, at least last. Okay, so 23 versus cross sample, which contains higher number of something is wrong in my keyboard. Control K does not work. That's why I am just putting one by one after another. If you also feel the same problem, please do this. I'm just picking this alignment. Look, I have taken this panel little bit bigger because I asked myself that I should put a map on there, and then I need a bigger screen, a big panel, so I just pick it. This way you can just make it as well. More beautiful. If you zoom in, you can also change the title, okay? Here you have to change the title. Look, Canada. Yes. Colombia, Brazil, Argentina, Peru, like this, okay? You can just, last thing is that, to save this, Ctrl S, as I said, I control P, so just save it manually, takes a little bit time. So, go slowly. Now the final one is that you can share this dashboard in PDF. So before that you have to make it just disable the edit option and then just share the total dashboard, the PDF file. Something is wrong, and then just click export, whatever letter, paper. I would like to before and last day. Okay, and export it. Willing PDF. Yeah, so that allows us, I have tried my best to do the things as quick as possible. If you like it, please subscribe and share to your friends so they can be. Okay, then just save it into your desired location. Let's start. Okay, I'm just saving it in my desktop. So, check it. Okay. This is your dashboard. Okay, so you can send it to your stakeholders, managers. Now, in this way, you can make a simple dashboard. Please, dear Red lovers, if you have any questions, please comment below. And goodbye for now. Thanks for watching.